This is Rob Tebbutt for Behind the Gloves. I'm here with lightweight champion Jorge Linares in Vauxhall, London. How are you today, Jorge?
Good. A little tired because, you know, every day I'm training very hard because the fight is coming. It's coming soon, September 23. And a forum, Los Angeles, California, so I'm happy.
How has it been settling down in London? Because you fought here several times in the past, three times, I believe, in the past?
Yeah.
So has it been different now you're living here full time?
No, I'm feeling good. I'm happy because it's a good opportunity for me. Good, a lot of auction here in the UK. I'm here. I'm moving to here from Las Vegas because my coach is Ismael Salas. He's working for David Head. So that's why I'm here. Different place, different experience. I'm happy. I have very good focus for the fight, and everything look good. But the fun is the next fight is in Los Angeles, and my opponent is Luke Campbell. He's from here. But everything look good.
One of the things that, particularly for me as a boxing fan, that I've really enjoyed about you and your career as a world champion is that you've always tested yourself. You're from Venezuela.
Yes.
You've had some fights in Venezuela, then
yes.
You fought in Japan,
yes,
and now a long time in Japan, and then America, and now in England and in London. Do you think that has helped you become the fighter that you are?
No, I'm looking for good play, you know, for good energy for me, good motivator for me. That's why I'm here. I have a lot of auction, a lot of opportunity for big fight, for good training camp. But I'm very happy. I'm very happy.
And for people who aren't as familiar with your earlier career, I mean, your career has had some setbacks. You've had some losses in the past.
Yes.
How do you feel that you are different now as a fighter? Because I mean, I was talking to your coach Ismael Salas, and he said that he feels that you're a different fighter now. You're more experienced. You're more of a professional.
Yeah.
Would you agree with that?
Yes, of course. I lose three times, big fight. But you know, that time I'm different person, different boxer, different experience. But you know, sometimes you need to lose something fight. You can take more experience and professional, because professional is hard, it's not easy, you know? Especially when you lose mentality, heart, everything. But I'm fine, I'm so fine. Now I'm good, I'm feeling very happy, and I feel very strong, more experience in my life, in my car. That's why I'm happy. It's my moment right now.
Do you feel that you're now in your prime of your career? This is the best stage of your career?
Yes.
Yeah, both physically and...
physical, mentality, everything.
What can you tell us about Luke Campbell as an opponent? I mean, how are you approaching fighting Luke Campbell?
Es un buen boxeador. Es joven, tiene ganas, tiene hambre, tiene bastante presión porque es inglés y ahora como mucha gente me está apoyando acá, se siente más comprometido, pero yo tengo que estar bien consciente que tengo que trabajar duro porque es un boxeador joven que quiere ganar el título mundial.
I know that you wouldn't be looking past Luke Campbell as an opponent. That's not the type of fighter that you are. But there has been obviously a lot of talk recently about a potential fight with Mikey Garcia. Is that a fight that you're interested in? Is that something that you might
sí,
look towards?
I'm very interested in that great fight. Sería la pelea más grande en mi carrera en esta categoría. Pero ahora lo más importante es seguir enfocado en esta pelea que tengo con Luke Campbell. Mucha gente dice que la pelea va a ser fácil para mí. Yo no pienso que sea fácil. Yo pienso que este deporte no es nada fácil. Es fácil es cuando tú haces una buena preparación y estás bien preparado, y gracias a Dios siempre la he tenido. Pero mi pensamiento es eso, porque no hacer una gran pelea con Mikey García en un futuro cercano.
Did you see Mikey García's last fight?
Yes.
Against Adrian Broner?
Muy buena pelea, la verdad. Hizo el trabajo que tenía que hacer, inteligente, fuerte, agresivo. Hay unos detalles pues que no los puedo comentar porque eso sería ya un estudio psicológico mío para un futuro cercano, pues hacer una pelea con él. Pero yo sabía que ese resultado iba a dar. Broner ya se le fue el momento, ya se le fue el hambre, ya se le fue las ganas. y Mike García pues está volviendo a regresar otra vez a conseguir todas sus oportunidades y está en su mejor momento, la verdad que sí. Pero no quita que hagamos una gran pelea él y yo.
How important do you think it's been to have somebody like Ismael Salas preparing you for this fight?
Siempre Ismael Salas tiene algo nuevo para mí. Siempre estamos haciendo preparaciones nuevas, combinaciones diario en el gimnasio. Y eso es lo que más me gusta de él. Yo me dejo llevar mucho de él, de lo que él me muestra, lo que él me enseña. Y la verdad que me siento muy contento porque cada día hacemos algo distinto. Todos los días sacamos un golpe nuevo, un mejor balance, una mejor estabilidad. Y la verdad que eso es lo mío. Lo mío no es un solo golpe, lo mío no es solamente la velocidad. Lo mío es tener de todo un poco, tener todo junto en el paquete. Y la verdad que eso es lo que me está enseñando bastante Ismael Salas. Y lo importante es que yo tengo como
saber. Ismael Salas, he's a very funny man. He is a character. And you look like you have a lot of fun in the gym. So
I like Salas because, you know, Salas is a very funny guy from Cuba. I like the energy in the gym because you can see Latin music, yeah. Salsa, sometimes I dance, you know, but sometimes I'm serious, I'm focused, you know, I'm strong, but it's good. That's why I love boxing. But it's not only work.
No, of course.
Sometimes you need...
I think some people sometimes they get confused and they think that to be focused you have to always be serious and you have to and I think that kind of you can see that in the way that you fight as well because I think that you are at your best as a fighter when you're relaxed.
You need to enjoy your
life. Yeah. Do you have a message for your UK fans? I know you've been doing your English classes.
No, I'm happy because now I'm feeling big support for all the fans in UK. That's why I'm here, that's why I'm training more hard, I have more motivated. So, thank you for everything, thank you for all the fun, thank you for all the messages. When I see my Instagram, my Twitter, that's why I like UK, I like the people, I like all the people.
Okay, well, Jorge, thank you very much for speaking to Behind the Gloves. I won't keep you any longer. You have a beautiful family here with you.
Yeah.
And I will let you enjoy your time with them because I know the time with them is precious when you're in camp.
Congratulations for you.
Thank you very much, Jorge. Thank you very much.
And if you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, make sure you go ahead and do so by clicking right here.